Hello friends, welcome to EduTap and also welcome to today's video wherein we shall have a quick look at one of the important concepts related to agriculture and rural development current affairs and friends, which is very important for the upcoming NABARD graded 2021 exam. And friends, I request you to kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel and also to our Telegram channel so that whatever the daily dose of free sessions and the free content that we upload on these two channels respectively can be utilized for your exam preparation, that is exclusively for the upcoming NABARD grade A 2021 exam. So friends, yes, are you feeling lucky today? Please try your luck by spinning the wheel and you may win up to 50% discount on courses of NABARD grade A as well as all the combo courses. The link to the spin the wheel is given in the description of the video. Kindly check it out. So friends, as part of the 5-minute series, the important topic that we are going to discuss today is agriculture census. So friends, here see, recognizing the importance of agriculture sector, whatever the contribution that it is making towards the Indian economy, what Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare has done is it started implementing the agriculture census scheme since 1970-71. Now this agriculture census in India has been conducted following, you know, basic or broad guidelines of the decennial world census of agriculture, that is WCA, which is evolved by the Food and Agriculture Organization. And our, though that is decennial WCA, our Indian agriculture census is conducted at an interval of every 5 years. Now let's see what's the history of it. Now in agriculture census, the operational holding, whatever the operational holding that is held by a farmer or a person, it has been taken as the statistical unit at micro level for various data collection, operational, etc. And operational holding is the ultimate unit for taking any agriculture related decisions, especially for agriculture census. Now, so far since 1970-71, 9 agricultural censuses have been conducted, and the 2015-16 census for which we are going to discuss today, that is the 10th agriculture census in that particular series. Now this agriculture census, it is like a scheme only. You know, for this they need funding and everything to run, to get through all the, you know, states and everything, to collect the data, to combine everything. Now so this was earlier a centrally sponsored scheme. Now after, you know, in 2007-8, what they have done is they have converted it into a central sector plan wherein the entire financial assistance, that is 100% financial assistance, is provided by the central government to states or union territories. So friends, now let's see the methodology of this agriculture census, how it is conducted. See, this agriculture census is conducted out in 3 phases. Phase 1, during this time, a list of all the holdings with the primary characteristics like what is, where is the area, what is the gender, what is the social group of the holder, location code, everything is collected. During phase 2, now here they'll get into a little bit, you know, detail like what is the operational status, what is the tenancy particulars, what is the cropping pattern, what are the type of crops taken in that particular area, all these are collected. Now phase 3, which is also known as the input survey, relates to collection of, you know, what is the pattern of the input use across various crops, regions and size groups of the holdings. So these are the various, you know, data that is collected in various phases. Currently for 2015-16, phase 1 and phase 2 results have already been declared. Phase 3 result we are yet to receive, or they are yet to be finalized. So friends, in methodology, in the earlier slide we have seen that there are size groups according to which these farmers are classified. Now what are those size groups? These size groups are based on the area that is being present with the farmer, like marginal, below 0.5 hectares to 1 hectare, small 1 to 2 hectares, semi-medium 2 to 4 hectares, medium 4 to 7 hectares or up to 10 hectares, and large 10 and up to 20 or even greater than that. So friends, now let us see what are the most important highlights related to agriculture census 2015-16. See, the total operated area in the country is currently 157.82 million hectares, which is actually a decrease of 1.11% when compared to 2010-11 agriculture census. Now, the highest percentage of share in 2015-16 was observed in marginal category. That is 24% of the area, that is total operated area, is with the marginal category farmers. Then comes the medium category farmers, then small, then medium small, and last would be the large category. So based on this, we have arrived that the average land, operational land holding, has declined to 1.08 hectares when, you know, in 2015-16 as compared to 1.15 hectares in 2011. So friends, continuing with the highlights of agriculture census 2015-16, the total number of operational holdings, here we are seeing the total number of operational holdings in the country, which have increased to 148 million from 138.35 million earlier. That is, it is showing an increase of 5.86%. So friends, this is one of the reasons actually for the decreasing average land holding area in our country. And the highest percentage share in the total number of operational holdings is observed from marginal category, 68.5%. Then comes a small, then comes a semi-medium, then comes a medium, and last large. And in a total of this, the operational holdings in our country, Uttar Pradesh has the highest number of operational holdings with 23.82 million, followed by Bihar, then comes Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. So friends, when it comes to the female farmers, that also is very important when we see the, you know, the changing dynamics of Indian economy or the country as such. The percentage of share of female operational holders has seen an increase of 13.96% when compared to the operated area, that is 11.72. In 2015-16, now the participation of female operational holders was highest in the marginal category, followed by small, and then the semi-medium category. So the gross cropped area was 191.76 million hectares in 2015-16, and the highest percentage share of, you know, the gross cropped area was observed in, again, marginal category, and lowest in the large category. And among major states, Uttar Pradesh is the highest, it has the highest share in the gross cropped area, 14%, because of the abundant water that is present, followed by Rajasthan because of the spices, that everything that they grow, and then comes the Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. Now, gross cropped area is something, the land would be same, but the number of croppings, how many croppings that you have taken in an agriculture year, that would be counted as a gross cropped area. So friends, let's have a quick look at the previous year question. This question was asked in 2019 mains, and the question says, as per agriculture census, the small and medium operation holding, small plus medium operational holding in 2015-16 have operated area of, now adding these two figures, you'll arrive at the figure 43.1%, which is the correct answer. Along with this, there were questions based on the size area groups, that is the small, marginal, medium farmers. That is also one important topic pertaining to this particular agriculture census 2015-16. Thank you very much, friends, for your patient listening. And if you have any query related to this video, you can always write to us at hello@edutype.co.in, or you can always call us on this number during working hours, that is 814-620-7241. And I wish you a very all the best for your exam preparation. Thank you once again.